here we go. I'm gonna be fixing this sculpt by one of my friends. And I'm probably just gonna focus on the face. And I'll try to make it look cool. It's a Captain America. Okay, so first of all, what I did is that he had his ears separate from the... You can see it separate from the head mesh, so what I'm gonna do right now is I'm just gonna turn them into one piece. Turn them into, I'm just gonna remesh this. It's all one piece. That soundtrack is better. Okay, let's see. Okay. It seems things are still... Let's see. I'm just gonna dynamesh it. Okay, never mind. I'm just gonna try to make it one mesh. There you go, group visible. That's what I needed. Now we're rocking. That looks cool. Nice. This one has a little bit more detail, so I'm just gonna use this. Okay, no more damage. Just going to project it all. Okay, I think that's pretty close, so I'm just gonna delete this. Symmetry, that's pretty cool. Okay, let's do this. See, providing soundtrack sounds. Okay, hold on. Let's do this. Oops. These are different subtools. Oh, that's a problem. Okay, so let's fix that. These are not merged. Okay. Okay, now this is gonna work. See if this works. Alright, that looks perfect now. Now everything, I mirrored it and welded the both spheres. So now things should work. Okay, I'm back. Sorry, guys. Okay, so we gotta check that the eyes are... Oh, what happened there? Cool. The eye distance should probably be a little bit closer. So I'm just gonna do this. Something like that. Yeah. Change the color of the clay to skin shade 4. You already have that. There we go. That looks a lot cooler. Looks like super sculpy, right? So you go to render, and then you go to render properties, and then you hit wax preview. Then you go to material, and then you can play with the strength of the wax modifier. So you can just go like that. You can go like that. Kind of like it like that. Looks like super sculpy. Alright, let's do this. So I'm building the eyebrow ridge up here and upper eyelid. Now the lower eyelid. These superhero types are always angry, so I like to make them pretty serious looking. If I can. Let's see, what can we use? Demon standard. Maybe. We can define the eyelid a little bit more. Notice that for, printing, whenever you're going to print something, you can see that, for example, my work is not as subtle as the work of, say, someone like working in video games, because I have to make things a little bit more exaggerated so that when things are printed, everything's there, everything shows on the print, because we've learned from sad experiences that 3D printers, although great, sometimes require a little bit of help in the form of us adding or exaggerating detail on the sculpt. So if you think like all the subtleties that you see on your model are gonna come out on the 3D print, they may, but it depends on the printer and it also depends on how deep you're cutting into your surface. So, although something pretty subtle might look amazing, you know, like a wrinkle or, I don't know, like a vein or something, you have to learn how much you need to push your model for that specific printer that you're going to be using. If you're using an HD printer like the Envision Tech, we have one here, or the, a Micro SLA, which those are amazing. There's no build lines. Everything looks sharp. It captures all the detail. Well, then, you know, it's still good to exaggerate detail, but you might not need to go as crazy, so. Okay, you see this little issue with the upper lid here? You can see how the line goes up and then kind of like becomes a little interrupted, and then it goes down and then it goes up again. Okay, so I like to fix those things by getting really close. And this is what we do here. We just make the pen size smaller or the draw size smaller, and then just pull and try to make it as perfect as possible, as straight as possible. That might not happen because maybe the mesh is like too soft, so when you pull and then you kind of polish, it kind of gets a little bit deformed. So I'm gonna subdivide it one more time, and this time it should work. Okay, see, pretty straight and nice. Okay, another thing that I like to do is I just pinch the edge of the eyelid. I'm creating a little flat area by pinching along the edge. So then what I need to do is like probably rotate this, and then I hit it with trim dynamic. And maybe Damien standard, because right here is like it has a certain thickness, then it kind of becomes a little bit wider. So I'm gonna try to keep that same thickness that I got going here by doing this with Damien standard at the very end of it. And then I'm gonna hit it with Damien standard again. And I need to subdivide again. Notice that I'm not using the the stroke feature called lazy mouse. I mean, you can use it, but I really don't use it that much. And then you could just do things a lot easier without seeing the effects of your shaky hand on the surface. So basically what lazy mouse does, it keeps your hand basically, or your stroke, steady. So it's not all over the place. So even if your hand shakes, it takes a while for it to register it. So what it does is that it keeps your lines pretty straight. Pretty cool. And then I'm kind of cleaning it up a little bit. Just, we don't want to leave this huge indentation. We'll make it as subtle as we can. See, and then when you look at it again, it looks a lot better, a lot sharper and cleaner. And I cannot tell you how important it is to do that when printing your work, because sometimes when you print and you don't do this, and your lower eyelid or upper eyelids are pretty subtle, then they merge with the sphere of the eye, and you can't tell where the sphere of the eye ends or the eyeball ends, and where the lid start, so you gotta be careful with that. Turn off lazy mask. Is that really?
It's bad? 7 o'clock.
It's 7 o'clock. I don't want to use it. So. That's weird. It's not letting me carve in the detail. Let's see, orb cracks. Oh, that's working. There's this fatty tissue right above the end of the perimeter of the outside of the eye, or what we call the eye corner. So you need to have that. And then here we could probably do this. Okay, we don't want to mess with the eyelids, so I'm just gonna cover the bottom or this bottom area, and then we can just move this around. Okay, this area seems to be really sunken in. I think we need to. The nose needs to come out more. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna cover this, protect it. Okay. And then I'm gonna pull out. And I make my circle a lot bigger, or the draw size bigger, so that I can actually affect more. If I just were to pull like this, then I'm only affecting the nose. I want to affect basically this area, all of this, except the eyes, obviously, the eyelids and everything. So. Then I make it smaller so I can just affect the nose. And then do that. But by doing that, I think I need to bring the forehead out a little more. Okay, I'm making it less dense so I can polish it a little bit more. You There's a clay buildup. Okay. And then this should be socketed in slightly. There's fatty tissue right under the lower eyelid, and that's what we call the eye bags or whatever, so I'm trying to work on that, but we don't want to make him look like he's super tired or anything, but I'm just trying to create that landmark, and then eventually I'll actually fix it and make it more subtle. But then you have the cheekbones here, which we need to address. High point here for the cheekbones. This needs to be more round. You see now it's beginning to take shape. It still looks a little weird, but we'll fix that. So we need to basically pull this up, pull this down if you want, pull this out a little bit, maybe pinch this a little bit, then the bridge here needs to be pinched. Jason Statham, or whatever his name is, from the Transporter. Halo. Okay. Let's see. Cleft of the lip. Basically, the mouth, or the corner of the mouth, basically ends right at the middle of, say... Oh, let me show you. At the middle of the eyes. So we have the eyes like this. That's where the corner of the mouth goes. Alright, so... See that? It's starting to look a lot better. Sometimes I just get lazy and just, instead of like using Demon Standard or Orcrax for carving, I just use the same brush. I just press Alt and go at it. This down here, this lower eyelid looks a little flat, so I'm gonna bring it out a little bit more. You notice I'm adding basically the muscle structure, the basic muscle structure, all over. Cleaning it up a little bit. I don't want to get rid of all I did completely, but I'm just smoothing out and basically blending in. This is what we would do in clay, and then I'm just gonna polish it a little bit more because it kind of became a little bit too swollen. Then I can always just bring it back in. If I were doing Captain America, I probably wouldn't make him this bulky looking in terms of his face, but my friend decided to make him that way, so I'll respect that. So I'm trying to stay true to what he did without being so invasive, but I mean, it's kind of hard. Transition a little bit less noticeable so it doesn't look as old. Carving in a little bit. Here we can build up the lips a little bit more. Same thing for this. It kind of does look like the transporter. Okay, I'm just gonna make it a little bit more. Exaggerated. Let's work on that. Okay, this is too sunken in, so we need to take it out. And now, deform the skull a little bit, so we need to fix that. Remember, guys, this is just a quick fixer-upper. This is not me going out loud in terms of detail and everything. So this is just primary and secondary form that I'm working on. So please take that into account. I'm making this video available for free so you guys can see what you can expect from my Patreon videos. And I'm also doing it to help out a friend, so... He was kind enough to actually allow you guys to have this video for free, so well, props to my friend for that. Now this is looking kind of weird, so I'm gonna fix it. At this point you can start adding textures and everything, maybe break the symmetry and start doing your thing. I'm not gonna do it. I'm gonna let my friend do it. But yeah, there's still a few things that you can work on and, you know, fix just to make this look a lot cooler. Add more material here to the side. Who knows? Maybe you can make this a little more obvious. I'm gonna lower the intensity to like 3 for this, and I'm just gonna start making this pop a little bit more. Let me bring this down a little bit. His eyes still look a little weird to me. I need to probably work on this. Yeah, there you go. But by doing that, I kind of messed this up, so I need to fix this. Okay. Maybe I need to. Memory. Running out of memory. Okay, so this is a basic look. Again, I think there's something wrong with these eyes. I just don't have a lot of time. I actually had to start working on other stuff. Okay, hold on. Still not happy with the eyes, you know. I don't have a lot of time to go over this, but the upper eyelid should be coming out forward more. Lower should be inside a little bit more like that. Give like more expression to the eyes. Maybe we can just do this, Just gonna cover upper area of the eye, the upper eyelid, and then maybe we could just do this. Have him squint a little bit more. That's not working. Ugh. Okay, so I'm gonna use this short hair brush, and you can find it online. I can't remember who gives it away for free, but you can find it on YouTube. And then all you do is, like, when it comes to placement, you move it to, say, 2.0.28, 26, something like that, and then you can just do this. Thank you. to the highest subdivision, and then do this. Something didn't come out, you can just polish it, clean it up. Nostrils should be a little bit more like this. But anyway, that's it, guys. Hope this helps somebody. Okay, just gonna polish that. That's not gonna work. Never mind, I don't know what's going on. Okay. Hope that helps someone.